Today, we've set up the Arbor Scientific Rotational Inertia Demonstrator. Now, this product is designed to help your students understand the concepts of rotational inertia, or in other words, the resistance to a change in the angular velocity of a rotating system. The cool thing about the Rotational Inertia Demonstrator is the ability to do quantitative labs and also help students derive a conceptual understanding of a pretty difficult topic. Now, when we take a closer look at how it's designed, we first find the axle, which is made with ball bearings for a near frictionless rotation. That's where our rotating hub is fixed along with these four spokes. They're spaced 90 degrees apart, which hold adjustable masses that allow for a variety of configurations. You can change the rotational inertia of the system by moving them closer to or further away from the axis. All right, now let's take another look back at the hub. It has three pulleys, and as you can see, they all have different radii. You'll need to use your own weight set, but in addition to the four spokes and four adjustable masses, the set does come with its own string and 90-degree clamp, so you can attach the apparatus to any ring stand that you might have. The impact the distribution of mass has on the overall rotational inertia of the system is easy to see, especially if you have two demonstrators side by side. By removing two masses and sliding the remaining two to the ends, and then comparing the angular acceleration with four masses moved closer to the axis, students can see that distance actually has more of an impact than mass on the overall rotational inertia of the system. For quantitative analysis, you can measure the distances of the masses from the hub to calculate their contribution to the overall rotational inertia of the system, and then add that to the rotational inertia of the hub and spokes. That value is given in our instructional guide, but it can make for a great activity for advanced classes. The unique part of this design is the ability to measure rotational inertia with other methods, like the falling mass that incorporate linear motion concepts that students are already familiar with. This is one of the only hands-on tools that teaches rotational motion. Once you're comfortable with all the ways you can tweak your variables, quantitative experiments will be a breeze, and qualitative experiments are actually possible in the classroom in real time. Now, if you're interested in actually seeing a teacher use this in practice, Jonathan Palmer of Flipping Physics has a great video that you can find on the ArborSci website, as well as his YouTube channel, Flipping Physics. Now that we've shown you how the Rotational Inertia Demonstrator works, we're excited to see how you use it in your class.